Short answer is yes, you could. So for example, you could go get food poisoning, and that would very quickly change your microbiome. Maybe not permanently, but it would definitely change your microbiome. But I guess the real question is, can we predictably change the microbiome to, say, improve our health, for example? And this is a hard problem. So you know, many of you may have heard of things like probiotics, where you try to introduce an organism into your gut microbiome. Well, a lot of commercial probiotics that you can get at the grocery store, these are organisms like bifidobacteria. These taxa that tend to be very low abundance in our guts, or at least in the guts of adults. And often when if you sequence the poop of someone who's taking these probiotics, you find that they'll take the probiotic and you'll see that organism in their stool, but as soon as they stop taking the probiotic, the organism washes out. It goes away, it doesn't stick. So it's hard to actually put a new species into the gut microbiome and make it land and make it stick permanently. Sometimes you only need a transient change in your microbiome to have some sort of health effect. So we know that even dead bacteria can sometimes modulate our immune response. So if you cooked microbes and fed them to someone, you could have a reduction of inflammation just because the molecules in the outer membranes of these dead bacteria are actually having a temporary drug-like effect on that person's system. But if you wanted to actually change and engineer and reshape the microbiome, we still are at the really early stages of being able to do that. And essentially, there's no clear way to engineer the system. It's like a game of pickup sticks, and you change one little thing and there's repercussions and ripple effects to the rest of the system. And so what we really need in order to do this well is an understanding of the niche structure and the ecological interactions that are occurring within a given person's gut microbiome, all those metabolic interactions of one microbe feeding another, the host giving, the human giving molecules to a microbe. Once we understand all those interactions, we can begin to find deficits in a given person. So say I sequence your microbiome, I look at your microbiome and I find, oh, you're missing species X, Y, and Z, or functional capacity X, Y, and Z. And then maybe I might have a freezer full of particular probiotics to make a customized treatment for you that fits your ecology. That's sort of a sci-fi version of the future for what we might be doing, but currently we don't yet know the basic ground rules for how to do this. So the answer is yes, we can change our microbiomes. I think eating fiber is usually a good thing. Having a complex, diverse diet that includes a lot of plant material kind of promotes diversity and promotes health in the gut. But as far as steering the ship in a particular direction or changing in a particular way to achieve a certain health outcome, we're still far away from actually being able to do that.